Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanna finally tackle this one question that I get asked every single time someone's taking a picture with me. Valeria, you're a model, so what do I do? How do I pose? How do make me look skinny? Everyone in general should know their good angles and how they should pose to take good photos. So I'm gonna tell you a few of my tricks to always get a good shot. Tip number one, lighting. And that's the most obvious trick ever, and I'm sure you guys already know that good lighting literally changes your life. So if you are shooting outside, try to shoot when it's overcast and not when it's sunny. When it's sunny, it creates like shadows on your face, and then your eyes are also squinty and watery. Not a great look. Even if it's sunny and you find like a shaded area, like an alley or something sketchy like that, that's a great place to shoot. If you're taking pictures inside, always try to find a window. The window is your friend. Natural lighting is everything. Just stand right in front of it. Right now I'm actually shooting this video. There's a window right behind this camera, and love you, natural light. If you are in a dark room or at a party, there's so many gadgets today that you can actually purchase to make sure you're gonna have a good pictures from your like girls night out or something, like the Lumi or this one. Wait, I have it. Portable ring light that you can just put on your camera. This was on my March favorites, and this is such a good option when you're out and you still want to get like a killer selfie. Invest in your future, okay? Tip number two, inspiration. When they came out with saved photos on Instagram, it literally changed my life, because what I do is I'll save pictures that I like, that inspire me. It doesn't need to be an elaborate picture, but just like emotions or just like a background or a pose or something. I always save it for inspiration to kind of give me something to work with when I think about pictures from my Instagram or even like family pictures. You don't have to stage like, you know, exactly the same thing, but I like safe pictures that I like their feel. Modeling shoots, most of the times when you come into the set, they'll have like a mood board, and you'll see pictures, a prints of, you know, of hair or makeup they're getting inspired from, or like movements, colors. So that's kind of where I took that inspiration into social media and just pictures for myself. Tip number three, when I take pictures standing, I make sure to separate my legs and bring right or left leg forward. It just gives your body a nicer shape. I make sure to shift most of my weight to the back leg. So what it does is that pulls you away from the camera, so it makes you look slimmer, and it kind of creates like a more, how do you call that thing? Like this flower, like a long flowery. The body always looks better in that, like always. Especially, I wear a lot of mom jeans, and if you put your legs together, the crotch area, not cute. If you wanna do a pose that's a little less dramatic, you do the fake walk. Put one leg forward, but it's not like a walk. It's just like I'm about to walk, but like I'm still thinking about it, you know? Putting one leg forward gives you the look of a longer leg, which is wonderful. Trick number four, emotions. So I don't recommend to do it when you're taking pictures with your family, because they might send you for therapy. But let's say if you want to create fun pictures for your Instagram, find faces and emotions that you know you look good in. I'll show you some of mine. I'm a nice girl. I laugh. Thinking about something. Someone's calling you, just like a bunch of that shit. So literally sit in front of the mirror and find like five looks that you know work for you and you look cute in. You know, take a bunch of pictures and have different emotions in it, and then choose which one you look better in. Next tip that I have for you is invisible heels. That's something that I've learned from shooting lingerie. I shot a lot of lingerie or swimwear throughout my career, and you obviously don't wear heels when you shoot that, because it looks unnatural. So what I always do is kind of raise my heels by 1 or 2 inches, and it just helps to make the body looks longer and leaner. It gives a really nice shape to it. Invisible heels. I wish it was a thing. like for every day. Trick number five. Okay, when you do take pictures with your friends or with your family, make sure that you join. I find that a lot of people do that when someone's taking their pictures and they just look straight forward and just smile and just like stand there for like 15 pictures. First of all, always ask to take like 5-10 pictures. I feel like everyone knows already. If they don't, they were raised by wolves. Hello. Make sure you make slight movements with your face. So let's say if someone's taking your picture, start with just like looking and then move a little your chin, then put it a little more up, then straight, then to the other side, or not the other side. If you know you have one side that's better than the other, that's even better. And just like, you know, just a little bit, nothing crazy. So do give yourself a little variety of slight movements. Trick number six, stage candid photos. So that's basically when you create a candid moment. I mean, all of us do it at this point where someone's taking a picture and you're like, okay, now I'm laughing, so like just take a picture, and you're like, then you're like moving your hair, or you're doing this, or you're tucking your shirt, or you're looking away, or you're pulling your pants, things like that. Always works. It always comes out very effortless, and it's like you didn't think about it, although you took like 15,000 tries of this one movement, and it was really uncomfortable holding yourself right there. Did I get it? Did I get it? Did I get it? I'm asking you to sit in front of a mirror and find your angles. Trust me, you need to do it once, practice, and you'll have great photos for the rest of your life. It's worth it. Another tip for all of you who want to create really good Instagram pictures, and you have husbands, moms, dads, sisters, brothers who suck at taking pictures. Most of my Instagram pictures my husband takes. My trick with that is literally create the moment, take my phone, I put it exactly where I wanted to shoot, I see where I'm gonna stand, and I let my husband just like, that's what I literally, I'm like, don't breathe, don't breathe, don't breathe, hold the phone, press the button, done. He is not allowed to move even an inch. I aim, I prepare the shot, you come, you press that button, and you're good to go. Happy wife, happy life. This is all, this is my quick little how to look good in photos. I hope you enjoyed it, and let me know what you think. Love you guys. See you next time.